not a moment that's wasted. Not a minute that's wasted here. There's not a moment that's wasted. There's not a minute that's wasted here. Oh, 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 how I long for you.
Precious to you.
Let it mean something precious to you. Let it mean something precious to you. And let it mean something precious to you. Let it mean something precious to you. You are my audience of one. Oh, let it mean something precious to you. Something precious in your sight. Jesus, I want to live a life pleasing to you. Something precious to you. Let it mean something precious to you. Let this be my sacrifice. Let it be my song. Let it be my song, only my song. Same meaning, same heart. Oh, it's a song that no one else can sing to you. Jesus, this is my song. Jesus, this is my song to you. Jesus, this is my song. Cost me anything, something that was just easy, something that was an afterthought, something that was so easy. I don't want to just bring you my leftovers. I don't want to bring you my scraps. I don't want to bring you my scraps. Oh, King Jesus, take my song. 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 This is my alabaster jar. song and let it be pleasing to you and let it be precious to you. Take my song, it's my gift to you. Jesus, Jesus, I want to bring an offering that's pleasing in your sight. Jesus, Jesus, take my song, take my life, oh, take it all. Find the most breakthrough. Yes, I know that once I give it up to you, you'll make something so beautiful. So let me let go of the thing that's hard to let go of. Help me let go of the thing that's so hard to let go of. So hard to trust you in. Help me let go and offer it up as worship to you.
Of another, not counting on the
of another. I'm owning my worship. I'm owning my prayer. I'm owning my faith. I'm owning my sacrifice. I'm owning my worship. I'm owning my prayer. I'm owning my sacrifice. My sacrifice to you. It's mine and mine alone. It's mine and mine alone. My gift to you, my song to you. Oh, 'cause all you ever wanted was connection, relationship. All you ever wanted was for me to talk to you. No excuses, no justifications, no blaming. All you wanted was for me to talk to you. All you wanted was for me to talk to you, God. Here I am, here I am. Here's my song, here's my worship. Worship that no one can give but me. It's worship that no one can sing but me. It's worship that no one can give but me. Worship that no one can sing but me. just like the elders around your throne, just like the living creatures around your throne who sing, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who sing day and night, night and day. Lord, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who sing day and night, night and day. Who sing, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Never ceasing, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Oh, who sing day and night, night and day, never measuring their offering. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. Oh, who sing day and night, night and day.
Holy, holy,
can come close. Oh, overwhelmed by holy, holy. Let me see holy, holy.
Jesus, you're beautiful.
My soul waits for you alone, just like the watchman wait for dawn. And here I finally found the place where we'll meet, Lord, face to face. soul I am longing for here in the secret place. Your nearness is all I am waiting for here in the quiet place. Here in the secret place. My soul waits for you alone, just like the watchman waits for dawn. And here I finally found the place where we'll meet, Lord, face to
This time, we'll be transitioning into a time of worship in the Word. We'll be meditating on Psalm chapter 24. We'll be praying and singing through it in smaller segments. So I invite you to open up your Bibles to Psalm chapter 24, verses 1 through 10. Again, that's Psalm 24, verses 1 to 10. verses 1 to 2. The earth is the Lord's, and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. For he founded it on the seas and established it on the waters. God, we love praising you. You are majestic, holy, awesome, worthy, and full of love. When there was nothing but darkness, God, you founded all the earth by your commands. All of the earth testifies that it belongs to you and you alone. You are worth the highest praise. And even though our whole lives and all our devotion could not measure up to what you're worth, still, we give it all to please your heart and to give you glory. And Jesus, even though you founded the earth on the seas, God, you are worthy of full glory and full authority. Still, you humbled yourself and took on the form of a servant and came to die for our penalty of sin. The highly exalted one who created all the earth overcame death and the grave for us, and we can never stop praising you.
How can my lips keep from singing your praise? How can I keep it in? Oh, how can I keep it in? When you, oh Lord, from the beginning, from the beginning of time, from the beginning, from when you said, let there be light, you've never stopped saying, let there be light. Oh, you never stop bringing light into the dark. Never stop saying, let there be light, let there be light. All the earth is yours. All the earth is yours. Oh, all the earth is yours. All the earth is yours. All the earth is yours, and all who dwell therein. All the earth is yours. All the earth is yours. O Lord God Almighty, all the earth is yours. Oh, come and teach me the gravity of this statement. Oh Lord, come and teach me what it means to know that you are the God of the heavens, God of the earth, creator of all things, the one who says, let there be light. Let there be light. You're the one who says, let there be light. Let there be light. You're the one who said, let there be light. Let there be light. You're the one who says, let there be light. Let there be light. All the earth is yours. Every heart therein, every soul therein is yours. All the earth is yours. Established us. You have established it. You have established us. You have established it. You have established us. You have established it. You have established us. All the earth is yours. All the earth is yours. You're the author and creator, perfecter of our stories, author and creator of the grandest, the biggest story there is. Author of time itself, you're the author, creator, perfecter. Oh, and yet you saw fit to choose us, and yet you saw fit to create us in your image, in your image. You saw fit to choose us, to invite us into your story, into your story, and save us and establish us in worth. You saw fit to choose us, to save us, to invite us in, and even give us authority to establish things on earth as they are in heaven, as they are in heaven. The same authority you gave Christ, you give us. Yet you saw fit, you saw fit to give us this grace, to give us this word, to give us this authority. The God of all things, the creator of all things, saw fit to give me authority, to give me a word, to give me authority. Oh, the God of all things, you're the God of all things, you're the God of all things, on heaven and on earth. You're the God of all things. You're the God of all things. You're the God of all things, on heaven and on earth. And not all know that you are God, yet you chose me to know that you are God. For not yet all know that you are God, yet you chose me to know that you are God. Oh, you chose me to know that you are God. Oh, you chose me to know that you are God. Oh, so how can I keep from singing your praise? How can I keep from singing your name? Oh, how can I keep from singing your praise? How can I keep from singing your name? How can I keep from singing your praise? that you are God. Oh, I know that you are God. I won't stop, I won't stop, I won't stop. For I know that you are God. Oh, I know that you are God. Oh, you chose me to know that you are God. Oh, you chose me to know that you are God. Amongst many who do not know that you are God. Oh, you chose me to know that you are God. So I will sing, I will sing. Oh, I will sing who you are and of your worth. Oh, I will sing, I will sing. I will declare who I know you are. Oh, I will sing, I will declare. Oh, I will sing who I know that you are. I will declare your worth, oh God. I will declare your majesty. I will declare that you are creator, you are the author, you are perfecter. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. None can establish like you do. None can take down like you do. Yes, you are perfect in all of your ways. Yes, you are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. Oh, God. Oh, you are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. None can establish like you do. None can tear down like you do. Oh, you are perfect. You are perfect. Oh, you are creator and author, perfecter of all things. You are creator and author, perfecter of all things. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. Over us. Oh, how can I keep from singing your praise? How can I keep from singing your name? How can I keep from singing your praise? How can I keep from singing your name? Oh.
Verse 3. Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not trust in an idol or swear by a false god. They will receive blessing from the Lord and vindication from God their Savior. Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek your face, God of Jacob. God, it's our greatest desire to be in your presence. We want to ascend the mountain of the Lord and be in the thickness of your glory, God. Father, it's not enough to stand far away and worship you from far off. We don't want to be like the children of Israel who didn't ascend the mountain because they were afraid of the glory of God. But Father, we want to enter. We want to be in the thickness, in the fullness of who you are, God. Every part of us, Lord, we want to come in. And so, Father, we ask for Jesus, who is the only one who is worthy to give us clean hands and a pure heart. Father, we don't want him just once or just on Sunday, but God, we want him every day to fully come upon us, to give us robes of righteousness, Lord, in every moment, Lord, because we want to stay in the thickness of your presence, of your glory, the fullness of who you are, God. That's the cry of our heart, Lord, for every barrier of sin to be broken off in our lives, Lord. Father, for every thought and intention of our heart to be pure and holy in your sight, to be pleasing to you, God. Because, Father, we want to stay in your presence all day long. And we want nothing to stand in the way between us, Lord. And we thank you that this is the generation of today. We want to be people who seek your face, God of Jacob. To know that you're a God of the present, that you're not the God of only Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, but you're the God of us too, Lord. And we want to enter into the thickness of your presence and your glory, God.
Show me your glory. Always, this love is every moment of every day. Always, this
This love is every moment of every day, always. This love is every moment of every day, always. This love is every moment of every day, always. This love is an everyday kind of love. Every morning I'm in it. Oh, this love is an everyday kind of love. And every evening I'm in it. Oh, this love is an everyday kind of love. Every morning I'm in it. Kind of love, and every evening I'm in it. This love is every moment of every day, always. This love is every moment of every day, always. This love is every moment of every day, always. Love is every moment of every day, always.
Verse 7, lift up your heads, you gates. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? He is the Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, you gates. Lift them up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is he, this King of glory? He is the Lord Almighty. He is the King of glory. Father, King of glory, we invite you into our hearts, and we prophesy to our hearts, to the ancient doors of our hearts, to those hidden places. Be lifted up, O you gates. Be lifted high, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. We invite you, Lord, into our families, into our homes, into our relationships. We want you to be with us in every part of us, Lord. And so we prophesy, be lifted high, be lifted up, you gates, you ancient doors. All those barriers of impossibilities, all those things that we thought were just impossible to change, we invite you, Lord, and we prophesy, open up that the King of glory may enter in. And we prophesy over this generation, God, that the King of glory may come in, that the high places may be brought down, and all of those ancient doors, all of those ancient customs, and all of those areas of our culture that are broken, that we've inherited, God, those ancient doors be lifted high, that the King of glory may come in.
The King of glory, strong and mighty, we invite you in. Laid the foundations of this world. King of glory, we invite you to come into every corner. There is no place you can't go, God. Nothing is too high, too thick for you to come crashing in, for you to come.
Just one whisper of your power and gates will open, Lord.
Oh, you don't go by force, but you simply say the word, even a whisper from you will do it.
You said, let there be light. You said, let there be life. You say, let the gates open wide. You said, let there be light. You said, let there be life. You say, let the gates open wide. You said, let there be light. You said, let there be life. You say, let the gates open wide. You said, let there be light. You said, let there be life. You say, let the gates swing open wide.
Let the gates open wide. Let the ancient doors open. Let the ancient doors open. Let the places that have been untouched for years be open now.
Open the walls, make your opening in every wall.
Every gate, every door, you don't miss a thing, Lord. King of glory, you don't miss a thing.
Let your glory flow in through these gates. Don't miss a thing.
Come blind us with your light. As the gates open, as your light floods in to every dark corner, come and blind us with your light. 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 Like this, that could come into our mess like this. King of glory, it's no one else but you, no one else but you.
Open our eyes to see the King of glory coming in. Open our eyes to see the King of glory storming through.
Don't wanna miss you, we don't wanna miss you, so open our eyes. usher you in. Open our eyes, open our eyes, that we may see you, that we may invite you in, oh God.
We want to see you flowing through, setting all things right.
Glory is here.
At this time, we'll be transitioning to a time of intercession. We'll be praying for Korea. So as I lead the prayers, I encourage you to come into agreement and lift up your own prayers. Father, we ask that you would anchor the fathers and mothers of this nation in their true God-given identity, that they can see themselves as image bearers, bearing your image, God, in this society, Lord. We pray that fathers and future fathers would have a restored identity, Lord. Their identity as protectors of dignity and virtue, that they are defenders of the weak, and they are channels of God's covenant blessing, just as Abraham was a blessing to the nations. We pray, Father, for a restoration of identity in our mothers, God, that mothers would rise up and know their identity from God is to be nurturers, givers of life, not only physical but spiritual givers of life, that their words have power to heal and to restore, that they are embracers of the lost and the broken, not only for their own children, but may they carry the Father's heart in this society, Lord, and bring restoration to the land, to carry the Father's heart to those who are weak and poor and broken in this society, Lord. Let's pray. Father, we want to thank you for family. Thank you for setting us into family to love us and to protect us. And I pray, Father, for the families that are in Korea, that people would be anchored in their families and that broken families would be healed and restored and full of peace, God. And we speak a blessing over families, over marriages, over parents' relationships with their children, God, that, Father, there would be a restoration of hope, that relationships can be restored. Father, we pray that children who have left their homes would return to their families, that they would not feel hopeless, but they would return home and really find their true nature, Father, in the nature of the family, God. That, Father, they would turn back to their fathers and the hearts of the fathers would turn back to their children, God. Father, we pray for specific protection over pastors and missionaries' families in this nation. Father, whether they're in Korea or abroad in different countries, God, we pray for protection over their hearts, God. That, Father, that you would keep that family within your love and care, Lord, and that there would be clear communication, Father God. Father, we pray for openness in families to share their burdens with one another, to share their dreams and their disappointments, God. And we pray that children would be seen as a blessing from the Lord. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for establishing the church in this nation. And we ask that your church in Korea would be anchored in you, God, and that her eyes would be open to the spiritual battle that we face, and that she would not lose sight of your commandment of love and unity. We pray against any division and fear in the church, and we pray, Father, that rather she would rise up to take her place of influence, speaking life and peace as the nation faces decisions like elections, military tension, and reunification. That God, rather than being divided by difference of opinions, that Father, they would be, the church would be united in love, Lord, and they would keep the perfect bond of peace, which is love. And that rather than disagreements, God, that they would really focus on battling the true battle, which is against the enemy, not with one another, Lord. And we pray that the church's anointing and blessing would overflow into all areas of Korea's society to restore the land. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for setting godly leaders in this nation. And we thank you for the godly leaders that you are yet to establish. Father, we thank you and we ask that the next presidential candidate would be of godly wisdom, not self-seeking, but first of all pure, then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere, for this is godly wisdom. We pray, Father God, for the believers who are in leadership positions, that they would hide God's word in their heart, that they would be full of wisdom and they would know and discern your ways, God, that they may follow in your will, Lord. And we pray that you would surround them with godly mentors, for godly voices to be heard in the government places, Lord, at every level, Father God. And we prophesy wisdom and truth to be upon the land through this current situation, Lord, as we face many decisions up ahead and big transitions, God, we know that you are the one in control. Father, and instead of being in fear or in doubt, Father, we choose to pray and trust, knowing that, Father, you know what is up ahead, God. And Father, we pray for your will to be done in this nation, Lord. Let's pray. Father, we ask that this generation in Korea would be set apart for you, that it would be different. That, Father, it would look to the examples of those who went before us in the Bible and really seek you, God. That the people of this generation in Korea would seek you above all else, Lord. And Father, we ask for your peace to be upon this nation at this time, God. Because we hear rumors of wars, and we hear rumors of violence, and we see division. But help us to really see with your eyes, God, to see the bigger picture of what you're doing, Lord. And really burden our hearts to pray, Lord, and to seek your face, God of Jacob, and to know that you are willing and ready to bring change, godly change, to bring your kingdom upon this land. But you're seeking those who will partner with you in faith, who will seek you and pray and believe. And Father, we ask that this generation would be that generation who seeks your face, Lord. And so we thank you for the honor to pray, to bless your heart, God, and to ask for your will to be done. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Now I know I have seen your glory that cannot be unseen. I am changed, changing still as I look upon you, Lord, and believe. Now I know I have seen your glory that cannot be unseen. I am changed, changing still as I look upon you, Lord, and believe. Holy is the Lord revealed before my eyes, and my burning heart can scarcely take it as I behold your beauty with unworthy eyes. The only song my soul can find to sing is hallelujah, 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 my King. Hallelujah. My King, lead my long. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, my King. Yes, Lord Jesus, we look upon you. We say hallelujah. Our King of glory. Our King of glory. Our King who's made a way for us to enter the holy place. Our King who's made a way to look upon you, to see you face to face. How can we keep from singing your praise, God, when we know who you are, when we know that you are the author, the perfecter of our faith and of all things, when we know that you are the God of the heavens and the earth, when we know that you're the God that chose us, that crafted us, that formed us, that brought us into light from darkness, when we know that you are the God that has transformed us from the inside out, who's delivered us and healed us and made us whole, called us beautiful and righteous, called us pure and lovely. When we know that this is who you are, God, may your praise ever be on our lips. May we not be able to escape your presence. May we always come running back for more. May we not let the distractions of this world and our selfish thoughts lead us astray. But God, let us keep our eyes fixed on you. This is what we want. We want to dwell with you. We want to dwell in your presence. Don't let us forget how sweet it is. You're so good. We give you all the glory tonight. In Jesus' name.